Hey everybody, hope you're doing well today. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to take SSD5 and separate each of the kit's elements onto their own tracks. As you can see, I've already done in this project. Why would you want to do this, you might ask? I think it's pretty clear you want to be able to mix them however you want, instead of just having one stereo track and trying to mix it that way and not being able to get it to sound the way you want it to. For me, this is a powerful songwriting tool. I like using MIDI drums for writing. I don't ever have them on my final products. I'll use them on my demos maybe, but I've got a real drum kit behind me. I have no excuse. But they are powerful writing tools because say you've arranged a song and then maybe you wrote some lyrics and you wanted another verse in, but you've already recorded real drums. You're either going to be cutting and pasting and trying to make it sound natural and probably failing at it, or you're going to have to re-record and your drums might not even be tuned the same way anymore. So it's kind of a nightmare to have to go retrack everything again. So drums are the last thing I will record, except maybe vocals. So I always take the MIDI route until I've decided fully on the layout of the song. But anyway, that's enough rambling. There's basically five steps to doing this. So step one, of course, once you've got your clean slate, no pun intended. The only thing I've done here is I've put Reastream on here so you can hear my DAW. It's sending the audio to my capture software. But what we're going to do is create 20 tracks. And 6 of these will basically be buses and the other 14 will be instruments. So if you hold Control T in Reaper, I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. And when I said hold Control T, I meant hold Control and hit T to create tracks. Sorry about that. Hopefully you didn't just make like 100 tracks by accident. All right, and now we're going to name the tracks. And I'm going to call this one Drum Bus. I'm going to call this one Snare Bus. And then snare top. Snare bottom. And the Hugo kit, which is the one I like to use, comes with a sample that augments the original snare. So we'll call this one snare sample. And then we'll say kick bus. Kick in. Kick out, Tom Bus, Tom 1, Tom 2, Tom 3, and Tom 4, Cymbal Bus, at least that's what I call it. You could call it Overhead Bus or whatever, but there's spot mics too. Slate has 2 spot mics, one for hi-hat, one for ride, so I just call it Cymbal Bus. So we'll call this one Overheads, or just OH for short. Hat Spot. Ride Spot. And now we have the Drum Room Bus. And we'll say Drum Room 1. And Drum Room 2. Alright, and now that's all of our tracks. And it might seem redundant to say drum room bus, drum room one, drum room two. That's kind of weird to say. Might seem redundant, but it's all in the name of labeling them properly. Because say you want to use these tracks and you bounce them down to audio and send them to someone to mix. If it just says room one, room two, they might you want it to be specific whenever you're naming your tracks. So it's just good habits. Pro tip from someone who's not a pro. So once you've got that done, we're going to basically put everything on their buses. But first of all, this drum bus here, while it will act as an actual drum bus, which will control the overall volume, if you put an EQ or compressor or something on this, it will affect the entire kit. We're not going to set it up like you would a real drum bus, and I'll explain that a little more when we get to it. But for right now, let's put the 3 snare tracks under the snare bus like this. Now let's put the two kick tracks under the kick bus. Put the four tom tracks under the tom bus. Put the three, the overhead and cymbal, the two cymbal tracks under the cymbal bus. And the two drum room tracks under the drum room bus. All right, now everything is bussed up. Now this is where it comes, this is where it becomes different than how you would normally set up a bus. If you were to be recording real drums, or mixing real drums anyway, you'd probably put all of your buses under the drum bus like this, so it has control of all these tracks. But when you're doing this with the plugin on here that's sending the audio to these tracks, it doesn't work right for whatever reason, so just leave it like this. Don't put everything in the drum bus, I guess. Just leave it like this, where they're equal to the drum bus. It'll still work that way, because this is controlling the plugin that is sending everything to these. So there you go. So that's basically step one, which is one of the longer steps, to be honest. Step two, we're going to put SSD5 on here, on the drum bus. And we're going to create 30 outputs. But first of all, let's go ahead and put the Hugo on here. That's the one I like to use. And you'll also notice, if I hit these drums, if you look up here, everything's just coming out of drum bus. It's not sending it to anything else yet. But we're going to get to that. First, for step two, go up here where it says 2 out of 48 out. Click that. Now we're going to, we've only got a stereo output, out L and output R. We need 30 outputs in total for the method that I use to do this. So every time you click this plus, it'll add two more. So we're going to go, we've got two, now we're going to go 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 20, oh, come on, 24, 26, 28, 30. So now we should have a total of 30. Scroll down and a little, make sure that it says 30 over there. It does on mine. Yep. And that's all you have to do here. And that's basically step two. Now step three is to make use of those. If you go to the mix tab in SSD5, you'll see down below each of these tracks, it says out one ST for stereo. That is what we're going to change. And if you remember the order that we made these tracks in, we're not sending anything to the buses, we're just sending them to those. What we're going to do is start with snare top. I don't use output 1. I don't use out 1 stereo because it'll just play through the drum bus. So the snare ring, which is a track I don't use because it's just unpleasant to me, and it's always off anyway by default. And the SLR is another one that I don't use, so we're going to turn the volume down on that. Because all SLR is like a snare resonant rattle. You can make another track if you want. Set this to 32 or 34 if you want the ring also. And just add more tracks like we did earlier. But anyway, that's enough rambling. Let's move on. Snare top. We're going to set the output 2 because we don't want it just going to drum bus. We want it to go to its own track. Snare bottom, we will set to out 3. Snare DIR, which is the sample, we'll set to 4. Kick in, we'll set to 5. Kick out 6. Tom 10 to 7. Tom 12 to 8. Tom 14, 9. Tom 16, 10. Then we'll scroll over. And we'll set overheads to 11. Hi-hat to 12. Ride to 13. Room to 14. And room B to 15. So now you know why we created 30 tracks or 30 outputs. They're stereo outputs, and we created a total of 15 here. Out one is not being used. That's why we have 14 instrument tracks. So it's a total of 15 outputs with one being unused. If that makes sense. So now if you try to play the kit, you won't get anything. Unless you didn't turn your SLR down. Then you'll just hear that coming through the drum bus. That's totally normal. We're on the right track. So now we go to step four, which is go to your drum bus here and click this little I/O button. And see where it says add new send. We need to add a send for every instrument track, but not the buses. So click add new send and start with snare top. Do it again for snare bottom. Snare sample. Kick in. Kick out. Tom 1. Tom 2. Tom 3. Tom 4. Overhead. Hat spot, ride spot, drum room 1, and drum room 2. Okay, now if you went back and tried to play now, you'd still get nothing. Because although we have a send going to those tracks, it's trying to send audio 1 and 2 from the drum bus to those tracks. Now, you want it sending to each track's 1 and 2, because that's their main input. But you want the output from drum bus to match what we set to each drum in SSD5. So in stereo, snare was output 2. In stereo, that will be 3 and 4. So now that we've set this audio 3 and 4 to 1 and 2 on snare top, if we go back and hit the snare on the kit, you'll notice the snare top works. So if you get where we're going here, go back to your I/O here and go to snare bottom. That will be 5/6, stereo source 5/6. And then you just continue on down the line. If you kept up with everything and did the same order I did, 7/8, everything will work out. 9/10. 11/12, 13/14, 15/16. Another neat thing, since it does send everything out in stereo, you're sending everything to their separate tracks, but it's still pre-panned from the software itself. And you can pan it more or less if you want to. You can go into SSD5 and change the panning under the mix tab right here where it says pan. See, these are pre-panned. Since it sends these out in stereo, they will already be panned even on their new tracks. So just keep that in mind. Sorry, I went on a tangent. I just thought about it while I was setting this up. But we stopped at 16, so next one will be 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. Or as Samus would say, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, and last one, 29, 30. Okay, now we have all of our tracks sent, we have all of our audio from drum bus sent to individual tracks, which are already prepared on their own buses to be mixed. So if you go back and play the kit now, actually, I'm going to take this here, this drum MIDI that I've already got from this project, and paste it over here. Once I hit play, you'll see all of the individual tracks are playing their sounds as they're supposed to. So there you have it. And that's pretty much it. You can mix it, go in, you can EQ, compress, whatever you want to do. And you can end up with something that started off sounding like this. And perhaps if it meets your fancy, you could make it sound like this. Or whatever you want to do. So just have fun with it. And if you guys want, I could export this as a project file. And all you need is SSD5 free. And you just upload or import the project file in the Reaper, and it'll already be set up. All you got to do is write your MIDI drums, and there you go. So yeah, leave me a comment if you want this, and I will do it just like this, but I will also get rid of this because you're not likely going to be using it. And it'll just be a blank project with the drums ready to be programmed. So simple, simple. But I do recommend you do this at least once. It will help you learn a little more about Reaper, help you learn a little more about SSD5. So do it at least once, just for brain reasons. But yeah, anyway, there you have it. You guys have a good day, and I will see you in the next one. Thank you.